Hi, welcome back. In this episode of Trust the Rust, we're going to finish watching the tractor pulls from the 2024 Puget Sound Antique Tractor and Machinery Association annual show. Each day of the show is a four-day show. Each day of the show, they put on a tractor pull. This is the second half of the video of pulling. So this is part two of the last day of pulling. So let's get right into it. Also, next video should be out Saturday or Sunday. It might be about something sitting behind you. I think I won't get your hopes up. I keep saying I'm going to work on this and then, well, nothing happens for a year and a half. Until recently. So anyway, let's get to the tractor pull and enjoy.
We got the super duper farm all in. I think he blew the horn past the cone. 6,500 pound, 4 miles an hour. Okay, we got a new tractor on the small sled. WD. He'll spin out at 209. So the farm all in is back. I don't know the story. It's the same class. Comes to the stop, full pull for the farm all super duper in. Moline Z, 4,000 pound, 3 mile an hour. She goes. 194. A little sum for you guys that do the track work right there. Okay, far side, we got the Farmall 400. 6,500 pounds, 4 miles an hour. Started to slow down and grab that TA and was able to keep going until he stopped at 232 feet. To our left, we got a John Deere 435. see what the judges call it. But I'm not getting a readout. I don't know if he cleared it quick as I could turn or what happened, but anyway, come back around, probably swap drivers. Oh, nope, they're gonna bring him back. Just said they're gonna bring him back. Apparently he didn't reset the sled. Farmall Super M-Key A, 6,500 pounds, 4 mile an hour. Over there on the far side of the track. Down to 239 feet. So that paid off for them. They didn't reset the sled, so they had to bring him back and rehook him. He picked a little different line on the track and it paid off. In the center of the track is a little softer where he was at. Right lane, a little, or right side of the track was a little bit harder and he got right down it. Side of the track, we've gone to 7,000 pound, 3 mile an hour with my brother on his Massey Harris 55. He's scratching inches there at the end before he stops at 180 feet. Mile an hour class goes 233 feet, 7,000 pounds. new class on the we have a new class on the small sled. We got a 4 mile H, 4,000 pound, 4 mile an hour. Powers out at 162 feet. All right, we got the W9 at the V8 International Power, 7,000 pounds, 8 mile an hour. Driver on the tractor as he goes 207 feet. 207. All right, we've got an Oliver 77 gas, 4,000 pounds, 4 mile an hour. And on the big sled, we have Alice Chalmers 185. And he's moved up to the 12 mile an hour class on the big sled far lane. If that's in front of the skid plate crossed the white line or not, but that's close to a full pole at 288 feet. The Moline Z, 4,000 pounds, 4 mile an hour, stops at 193. Okay, the Farball 560 is Cummins. He's back, 12 miles an hour, 7,000 pounds, and we got the black WD on the trying to read the sign. 4,000 pounds, 6 miles an hour. Coming up next. Judges, and he goes 257 feet before he spins out. Okay, here comes the black Alice. WD goes 234 feet. Okay, the W9 of V8 is back. 12 miles an hour, 7,000 pounds. Triple four, matching hair, near side.
one.
Okay, Oliver 770, 6 mile an hour, 4,000 pounds. Gone up to 8,000 pound, 3 mile an hour. Next on the sled is a John Deere 70. At 181 feet. Next, you got the WD-45 back on the sled, 6 miles an hour, 4,000 pounds. And stops at 210 feet. Okay, quick explanation. If you don't know tractor pulling or how we're doing this, each class we start, let's say 5,000 pounds, just like Rand did. We start at 3 miles an hour, and then we go up each mile per hour class. We don't do all the threes in each weight class, we just do incremental. That way you don't have to go back and forth throwing weights. So you'll see a 3 mile an hour, maybe some fours, sixes, eights, 12s, if we have some to fill the class. If we don't fill the class, or even if we do, we'll go up to the next weight bracket, which could be 5,500, and we'll start over at 3 miles an hour and work our way back up to 12 miles an hour. There's a tractor sneaking up on me. Oh, he's barking it. All right. Okay, we got John Deere 70 on the big sled. Got the WD headed our way, 6 mile an hour, 4,000 pounds. 70 stops at 130 feet. might think, wow, that's pretty close. Yeah. There's the cone. That's the sideline. That's out of bounds. There's the dirt. No, we don't have chalk out of bounds this time. We haven't all week. I mean, shoot, just the last 2 days of the show, we've had chalk down the middle. So I am close. I am not on the track. I don't have any safety colors on, so I'm not supposed to be on the track. So anyway, maybe sometime I'll get a media badge and then they'll let me on. All right, next hook. All right, 8,000 pounds, 4 mile an hour, we got it over, Super 99. John Deere 720. Things up on the near sled, 8 mile an hour, 4,000 pounds. Here we got the black WD coming our way. And he'll get stopped. 190 feet. He's the first in the class and he's re-signaling to re-hook. All right, one of our John Deere 70 is back on the sled as he moved up to the 4 mile an hour class, 8,000 pounds. It's not his first day pulling, not even his first hook, but it is Wednesday of this week, today's Saturday. Wednesday was his first hook. Love to see new people come out and try this. Okay, here comes Black WD. Chose to rehook. He wanted to go back, so he has to accept this next footage I'm about to read off. 196 feet. 196. All right, 6 mile an hour, 8,000 pound big sled. Got a 190, Alice Jones. 188. All right, far side of the track, we've moved up to 9,000 pounds, 3 miles an hour. Up next, near track, we've got the 770 coming at us, 8 mile an hour, 4,000 pounds. He comes to a stop at 160 feet. Ford's at it again, 8 mile an hour, 4,000 pounds. Oh, he's flirting with that center line. He wanted to stay legal. So he just went 221 on the Funky Ford. Big sled, we got another Oliver Super 99. Stop at 192 feet. Well, I think on this small sled we're 4,500 pounds, 3 mile an hour. I see 3 mile an hour. I think 4,500 pounds. The tractor's sitting down in front of the sign, so I can't read it. So, first in the class of WD goes 158. Big sled. 1,000 pound, 4 mile an hour, we got the Minneapolis Moline GB diesel, and she stops at 239. Here we got a Farmall 8, 4,500 pounds, 3 mile an hour. Yeah. the big mass he goes, 242. Jailbreak. Full pull. And see, that was 9,000 pounds, 6 mile an hour for the Farmall. Alright, we've got a Farmall H, near lane, 4,500 pounds, 3 miles an hour. Big sled. Dallas Chalmers, 190 is back. 9,000 pounds, 6 mile an hour. Again, we've got the International 1066 at 8 mile an hour, 9,000 pounds. And he'll spin out at 220 feet. Small sleds, we've got the Alice WD. And he'll run out of traction at 160 feet. Okay, that last Alice, first of the 4 mile an hour class on the small sled. Is in the 8 mile an hour class yet, and she'll get stopped at 218 feet. Back here we got the John Deere 435, 4 miles an hour, second hook in that class, stops at 109. All right, we're speeding things up, 4,500 pounds, 6 miles an hour, here comes Bocephus. Matching errors, 444. He will get stopped at 187. Big White, International, 856. Continue on with 6 mile an hour, 4,500 pounds with the Oliver 770. stopped at 180.
Okay, big sled, we got the Alice D21 of Bob Vanderploo. Small sled, we got my dad back on the sled with the 770. He's gonna speed up to 8 mph, 4,500 pounds. We're just about done to the small sled. I think we have 2 hooks left. Yeah, there's my dad, 8 mph, 4,500 pounds, 188 feet. It's kind of cool the way the shadows are starting to come across the track. Makes it feel like falls just around the corner. Even though it's only, what, the 3rd of August? £9,000, 12 miles an hour, International, 1256. He'll reach 237 feet. Okay, small sled. We still do have a few hooks remaining. We're doing the 50-50 class, I believe it is. So it's going to be like 4,750 pound, 3 mph.
Marmol 300 goes 185.
Big White's back on the sled, 12 miles an hour.
A tractor length of a full pole, 275 feet. Super 77 stop. 171 feet.
All right, I think we got a new class on the big sled. 3 mph, I'm gonna guess 10,000 pounds.
Stop at 224. Okay, back to the near lane. Got a Farmall 350. Stop at 162. got the Massey 97 back on the sled. 3 mile an hour, I think 10,000. Got the triple four Massey Harris on the way. 4750. 3 mile an hour. As they both stop at the same time, Massey stops at Massey 97. Stops at 209. The triple four Massey Harris stops at 172. International 1066, but it stops at 157. After talking for a while, you start to get a little tired and tongue-tied, and your throat starts to get sore and dry. Doesn't matter how much water you drink, but it's part of doing it, and I like it. All right, that should have been 3 miles an hour, 10,000 pounds. She gets to 180 feet. Alright, this should be... Shoot, I don't remember. 10,000 pound. Oh, we got somebody changing the sign for us. Anyway, we got a John Deere 830. Yep, 10,000 pound, 3 mile an hour. This is official. Stop at 182. New driver, new class. 10,000 pound, 4 miles an hour. And he'll stop at 162. All right, John Deere 80 is next. Next, we've got an Alice Chalmers D21. Looks like a 6 mile an hour class, 10,000 pounds. 7.
All right, we're going to speed things up again. 10,000 pound, 12 miles an hour. And the first hook is going to be that Farmall 1256.
Spin out at 222 feet.
So, the guy on Big White is a brother to the guy on the Farmall 1256. I'm not saying this is bragging rights at the dinner table on Thanksgiving, but we do have one more pull in September. But let's see who goes for the dinner rights.
Bragging rights at the dinner table.
Taylor's got the bragging rights for the next dinner table, whether it's Thanksgiving or whenever. Taylor just went 231 and beat the 1256's 222 feet.
All right, we're gonna go up to 11,000 pound, 6 mile an hour. We'll have the 1486 up next. Get stopped at 206 feet.
All right, next up, Oliver, 2255.
I believe it's 8 mile an hour class. At 211 feet. All right, got an Alice 210, 1,000 pound, 8 mile an hour. Put the clutch in at 210 feet.
All right, looks like the Oliver's back. New driver, 12 miles an hour, 11,000 pounds.
And he gets down to 240 feet.
All right, I think that's the last tractor hook. I'm pretty sure. Don't count on it. But I know we're going to close the show out with Big Bertha doing another full pull wheel stand. cow. Well, that puts that'll close the books for 2024 here at the Puget Sound Antique Tractor and Machinery Association's annual Vintage Farming Days. Hey, I'd like to thank everybody, the track crew. Really appreciate the track crew. All the work they did to get this track in shape from the beginning of the week. As we had at least an inch of rain, maybe inch and a quarter, we had new dirt, it soaked in and made a mess. It was spongy everywhere. It was miserable. And then I'd also like to say thank you to all the subscribers or viewers that came up to me and said hi, bought a shirt, bought a sticker at the show at Rand's Snack Shack. And that's about all I got to say today. Anyway, thanks for liking, subscribing. If you please, share that with your friends. And we'll see you in the next video. Thanks. Bye.